Morgan Wallen has announced that he will no longer be performing this weekend on Saturday Night Live. The country singer posted a video on his verified Instagram account Wednesday talking about what happened. He started by saying it was a tough video for him to make, but a necessary one. I was getting ready for SNL this Saturday and I got a call from the show that I will no longer be able to play, Wallen said. And that's because of COVID protocols, which I understand. The announcement came after a TikTok video showed a man identified as Wallen drinking and appearing to be at a party without a mask went viral. CNN has reached out to both the poster of the video and Wallen for comment. Wallen went on to say that he had not tested positive for COVID-19 but added that my actions this past weekend were pretty short-sighted, and they have obviously affected my long-term goals and my dreams, he said. I respect the show's decision because I know that I put them in jeopardy and I take ownership for this. I'd like to apologize to SNL, to my fans, to my team for bringing me these opportunities and I let them down. CNN has reached out to SNL for comment. The 27-year-old singer said he believes he has some growing up to do and will be stepping away from the spotlight for a bit to work on himself. I wish I could have made country music and my fans proud this Saturday, but I respect the decision once again, he said. Lorne Michaels, the creator of SNL, actually gave me a lot of encouragement by letting me know we'll find another time to make this up, so that means a lot to me. Thank you. SNL resumed performing from the set with a live studio audience this past weekend when it was hosted by Chris Rock, with musical guest Megan Thee Stallion. Bill Burr is set to host this weekend, and as of Thursday morning a new musical guest had not been announced. SNL nixes Morgan Wallen appearance after singer violates COVID-19 safety protocols. One of country music's hottest stars says his invitation to appear this weekend on Saturday Night Live has been revoked. Morgan Wallen, whose hits include Whiskey Glasses and Seven Summers, posted an emotional video to his Instagram page saying show executives nixed his appearance for violating coronavirus safety protocols. I got a call from the show letting me know I will no longer be able to play, Wallen said in the video, which he says was recorded in his New York City hotel room. I respect the show's decision, because I know that I put them in jeopardy and I take ownership for this. He apologized to the show, his fans and his team for bringing me these opportunities, and I let them down. His cancellation comes days after videos posted to TikTok surfaced showing Wallen, without a facial covering, at a crowded bar. The videos were taken Saturday in Tuscaloosa, where Wallen got up close and personal with fans partying with revelers after the University of Alabama Crimson Tide trounced Texas A&M, according to L.com. Wallen, who broke onto the music scene after competing on the NBC talent show competition The Voice in 2014, received backlash from people accusing him of having a lax attitude toward the virus. I wish I could have made country music and my fans proud this Saturday, Wallen said. Wallen said the sketch comedy's longtime showrunner spoke to him directly. Lorne Michaels actually gave me a lot of encouragement by letting me know that we'll find another time to make this up, so that means a lot to me, Wallen said. Comedian Bill Burr is set to host this weekend's show, and while the SNL official Twitter page has teased a parody of Wednesday's debate between Vice President Pence and Senator Kamala Harris, the show has not announced a musical guest to replace Wallen. Country music star Morgan Wallen said Wednesday that he had been disinvited from performing on Saturday Night Live this coming weekend after breaking health and safety protocols. Wallen made the announcement after videos posted to social media showed him partying without a mask in Alabama last week. This is a tough video for me to make, but a necessary one, Wallen said in a direct-to-camera address posted to Instagram. I'm in New York City in a hotel room. I was getting ready for SNL this Saturday, and I got a call from the show letting me know that I will no longer be able to play, and that's because of the COVID protocols, which I understand. While Wallen said he had not tested positive for coronavirus, he called his actions pretty short-sighted and acknowledged it had obviously affected my long-term goals and my dreams. I respect the show's decision because I know that I put them in jeopardy. And I take ownership for this, he added. Wallen, who was named Best New Artist at this year's iHeartRadio Country Music Awards, attended a college football game between the University of Alabama and Texas A&M last week. In multiple videos posted to Twitter and TikTok, he was seen in close proximity to maskless fans without wearing a face covering himself. On Tuesday, Wallen's revelry was picked up by sites such as Vulture and Deadline, both of which noted how his disregard for coronavirus guidelines potentially undercut the safety of the Saturday Night Live cast and crew. In his video, Wallen apologized to the show, as well as his fans and management team. I wish I could have made country music and my fans proud this Saturday, but I respect the decision once again, Wallen said, adding that executive producer Lorne Michaels had given him encouragement and suggested there might be an opportunity in the future for Wallen to appear on the sketch comedy series. That means a lot to me. Thank you for that, he said. Saturday Night Live returned last week for its first live in-studio episode since March. The show adapted its production to comply with New York State protocols, including paying live audience members as a way to circumvent a rule that limits in-person attendees to show employees. As Michaels previously explained, SNL also adopted a number of other tweaks, including restrictions on the number of people who can be on the studio floor at one time. If a camera's not in use in that sketch, the operator would leave, Michaels explained to the New York Times. When sets have to be changed and the stagehands come in to do it, others will leave. We have a finite number of people and that's being closely monitored. Asked what would happen if someone on the show tested positive for coronavirus, Michaels said, everyone goes into quarantine for 2 weeks if you test positive. Saturday's episode is hosted by comedian and actor Bill Burr. No replacement musical guest for Wallen has been named just yet. More great stories from Vanity Fair, a first look at Diana and Margaret Thatcher in The Crown Season 4, celebs roast Trump in rhyme for John Lithgow's Trumpty Dumpty book Brace Yourself For, George Clooney's apocalyptic movie The Midnight Sky, the best shows and movies streaming this October, inside Netflix's latest binge-able escape, Emily in Paris, The Crown's young stars on Prince Charles and Princess Di, from the archive, how Hollywood sharks, mafia kingpins, and cinematic geniuses shaped The Godfather. Not a subscriber? Join Vanity Fair to receive full access to VF.com and the complete online archive now.